Hey, you do. Welcome to video number 12 of my little NixOS configuration series here on my YouTube channel. And in today's video, I want to create a basic package of a script I am using all the time. And for those of you who have seen the last video, in the last video, I went over some basics on how to package a shell script on NixOS. And today we will do that with an actual script, and we will fetch it from Git and install it to our Nix store. And the script I want to install to my Nix store is basically just something like a project launcher for Zellij. For those of you who don't know, Zellij is a terminal multiplexer like Tmux, where you can have different windows and panes in the same terminal. And I think I came across this idea when I was watching the Primogen, when he demonstrated how he works with his window manager and Tmux and so on. And I found the script he used in Tmux quite interesting. And then I thought, okay, I can just do something for Zellij, because I, for myself, switched over from Tmux to Zellij, I don't know, somewhat last year ago. The script will basically just open a fuzzy finder, and it will fuzzy find in project directories I have defined in an environment variable. And here I can just search for my project, and then it will open a Zellij instance, or it will attach to an existing session, and this will load a predefined layout. So up here I have NeoVim for my code editor. Down here I have a terminal, and just here I have some funny matrix code running. And what this also does, it will change the directory to my project, so I can just access all the project files here and just open them in NeoVim. It's basically the setup I used before when I did some coding and stuff. And as you can see in my videos right now, I'm trying out Zed, and I still have not decided if I keep using Zed or if I go back to NeoVim, but that's another topic. So that's what we are going to build today. When we are back in our Flake, the first thing I will do is I will create a new branch for my video number 12 here. And the first thing we need to do really is to define a package for the script I was talking about. So as you can see, the script is written for fish. What I would like to do is I would like to create a self-contained package so anyone can use that package, no matter if fish and fuzzy finder and so on is installed to the system. So we will define a package for the script, including all dependencies in Nix here. And our flag, I have a folder called packages. And here I will just create a new folder named by the script. And within that folder, I will just create a folder.nix. I don't want to go too much into detail what the structure here is for the package, so I will just quickly cross over everything because we discussed that in detail in the last video. I will just paste in the basic structure we are working from. So we have the standard environment as an input to our function here, and then we call the make derivation function, and the package will be named zellij-ps for project switcher. Here we have the version, the build inputs, and down here I have an empty install phase. As this is just a shell script, this is basically the only phase we need for the Nix package builder, because we don't need to compile any software or apply any patches in advance. So this will be very simple and straightforward. The most important part here is basically that we have the source code available. So we will define the source here. In the last video, we had the source code just lying in the local folder. This time, we will do it a little bit different. We will fetch the source code from a Git repository. And for that, I will just enter a new function argument, which is the fetch from gt function. There's also one for GitHub and GitLab and so on and so forth. In the source attribute, we can just use that function. And in order to fetch the source code, this function needs a couple of values here. First of all, as we fetch the code from a Git function, which is a self-hosted Git solution I have on my own server, I need to specify the domain where to fetch the source code from first. And then you have some other values that you would also, for example, use in the fetch from GitHub function. You have the repo owner, and then you have the name of the repo. And then Nix wants to know exactly what you want to fetch. So in this case, we also have a ref attribute and we have a SHA-256. And of course, you can just go to the remote repo and look them up and copy and paste them. But there's also a simpler method in NixOS. So you can just go for Nix run and then Nix packages. And there's a little helper program that's called Nix prefetch git. And then you just give the URL of the repo. This I can just basically run, and this will fetch the information I need up here. So I just want to have the latest version. And of course, I could just give an exact commit to the Nix prefetch git to get exactly the commit version I want. But in this case, that's not necessary. And then I can just go here and copy this over here. And here we have the hash and just copy that in. And down here, I will just quickly define the install phase. And as we had in the last video, this is just basically a simple bash script. We make a directory named bin for binary in the output. And the output is basically the path in the Nix store that package will have after it is built. And then we copy the fish script to our output folder. And what we also do, like we did in the last time, is we wrap the output. So the path for the package is prefixed with all the dependencies, which are in this case, the shell FD as a support program for the fuzzy finder here. And of course, we will need Zellij. And as you can see, I got a couple of red flags here. And that's because we don't have everything available we need. So first of all, we will need lib. And then you can see my code completion already offers me some of the other requirements. And in order to use the wrap program script here, we need to add some native build inputs. The wrap program is provided by the make wrapper package. And of course, we also need to get that into scope here. And now our package is basically complete. We have to make derivation function. We have the pname and the version, which will in the end be responsible for naming in the Nix pass. So we have the program name with the version attached. And we fetch the source code from Git. Build inputs are not necessary because this is just a script. And for the native build inputs, we have the make wrapper. And this allows us to wrap the program down here in our script. And normally what you would do, you would add some meta information. And now our package is pretty much defined up here. And of course, in our packages folder, we have a default.nix file. And in the default.nix file, we can just uncomment this one here. And what we will do here is we will just define a name and basically just import our package here. And the good part is when we go into our flake.nix file, you can see here that we basically already imported everything that is on the packages folder. So there is really no need to modify our flake here. So we can just go to our home directory, our username, and then go for home.nix, and then we can just enter the package name we have just defined and save it. And of course, we made some new files, so we need to add them to our Git repo. And now we can rebuild our configuration. And now it will build the system, and everything has succeeded. And then I can just go to my virtual machine and just have a look if our script is available. And it is. The script basically gets the list of the project folders it needs to look into from project_folders environment variable. Just for now, I will just set this manually. So I'll just put this to my config folder. And now you can see I have access to all the subfolders in my config directory. And this won't do very much because, as you can see, there's no layout file present. And as I said, the script refers to a layout file, which is just called Zellij-ps. Just for brevity now, I will just copy this over from my main machine here. And now when I try this again and just choose some random folder, you can see that basically the same layout as on my main machine is opened. And here it's complaining it doesn't have Unimatrix because that is not installed on this machine. But up here, I can just work as I just did on my main machine. When we have a look here, Zellij is not really globally available in the system because this is just encapsulated into this package we have just created. The good thing when creating packages with Nix, you can basically make sure that all necessary dependencies are included and you have everything available at runtime, but it does not necessarily mean that the programs you're using for your package are globally available on that machine. That's basically it for this video. On the next video, we will continue this a little bit. So next time I will show you how we create a home manager module, because right now we have built the package, we have been able to use the package, but the main goal and the main thing really about NixOS is that you have kind of everything built out from your NixOS configuration, and especially that part where we had to copy over the layouts and where we had to set the environment variables. I don't know, that's for one package you can do that, but when you have a lot of stuff you need to configure, it's really better when you have all of that in your NixOS configuration. So next time we create a home manager module where we can exactly define everything else that we need for this package. So we will define a default layout and we will basically make it usable as any other home manager module. So that's it from me today. See you next time. Bye bye.